This is Radio Health Journal. I'm Nancy Benson. This week, genetic testing for disease risk and genomic testing for cancer treatments that really work.
People who would have probably passed away within 3 months are thriving. And in cancer, this is why we do it.
Genetic and genomic testing when Radio Health Journal returns.
I'm Reed Pence, the producer and host of Radio Health Journal. If you like listening to Radio Health Journal, you'll also like our sister show, Viewpoints, which covers a wide array of topics, from education to history to the environment. Here's a preview of what they're covering this week on Viewpoints.
This week on Viewpoints.
The more we continue to retouch photographs, the more we as a society are setting the stage for an unrealistic expectation of what beauty is.
The permanent consequences of social media. Then.
They wouldn't have water to fight it. This was at best a rescue job, and yet they went up anyway.
The heroes behind 9/11, their stories and more. I'm Marty Peterson.
And I'm Gary Price. These stories in depth this week on your public affairs magazine, Viewpoints.
Listen to Radio Health Journal and Viewpoints on your favorite radio station. And subscribe and listen anytime on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, and Spotify. Also, follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Radio Health Journal.
Americans are in a genetic testing frenzy. Last year, more than 13 million of us took an at-home genetic test, doubling the number who had taken one before. Curiosity about our ancestry has been the biggest driver of the tests, but that's starting to change.
About three-quarters of Americans that we surveyed, so we surveyed about 1,500, and 75% of them ranked health information as their top interest for testing.
That's Juliana Cintron, a genetic trends expert at 23andMe, which has done a nationwide survey about people's attitudes towards genetic testing.
For a long time, we've seen this interest in ancestry and people wanting to know where they come from, and now they're taking a turn for health. So they're interested in learning about their own genetic health risks through tests like 23andMe, and also how it can not only impact themselves, but their children. About 66% of Americans are interested in learning about genetic variants that they can pass on, since this can increase the risk for certain diseases.
That's why today's at-home genetic tests could be called more useful than those that simply tell you where in the world your ancestors were from.
This information can be really empowering and lead to not only informed decisions, but better lifestyle choices. And what a lot of people don't realize is that ancestry and health actually go hand in hand. There are some genetic diseases that are more prevalent in people of certain ethnicities. And so knowing your ancestry can help you when you find out about your genetic risk for something. So we're able to tell you about your genetic health risks for certain things, and these are whether or not you have a variant that can increase your risk for certain diseases, things like late-onset Alzheimer's disease, Parkinson's disease. Now, these are really sensitive reports, and we give the option to our customers on whether or not they want to view this information. We also have carrier status tests, and those are the ones that can tell you if you have a variant that you can pass on to your children.
However, if something comes up on a genetic health scan, 23andMe advises patients to see a genetic counselor. Experts say there's good reason.
Knowing more information about your genetic makeup can only be helpful. The one thing I would say is that I wouldn't get too shocked by something that you see, because there's a lot of information that cannot be conveyed through one of those tests.
Dr. Marcia Bros is Associate Professor of Head and Neck Surgery at the University of Pennsylvania School of Medicine and the university's Abramson Cancer Center.
Some things can look very, very frightening, and it turns out they're not things that you need to worry about at all. So I would just say, to get the context and the importance of the findings, it's really important to speak to your doctor. Sometimes a variant in a gene is not going to cause an actual syndrome. So they might say you have a variant in a gene that's associated with breast cancer, for instance, but we may know that that variant is unlikely to cause cancer, but that may not be very clear from the materials that they get. They just say, oh, I've got a variant in this thing, and a person who gets that report might be frightened by that when it turns out it's not something we would worry about. So it's really important to get somebody to interpret it, like a genetic counselor or somebody who actually understands the test and the different types of results you might get.
And if you already have cancer, genetic tests are becoming more important as well, or more correctly, genomic tests, where doctors scan the genes within tumor cells.
It means taking tissue from somebody's cancer and saying, are there any mutations that are specifically in that cancer that's causing either changes in the behavior of those cells or even causing the cancer to start? And an example of that is recently TRAC fusion cancers were found to be very, very well treated by a TRAC inhibitor drug. And so we want to check people's cancer to see if they have this thing called a TRAC fusion. It's a type of genetic abnormality. Because if they do have it, we really want to make sure they get that drug. So it's a very different purpose. The purpose of it, and we're talking about doing genomic testing on a cancer right now, the reason we're doing it is because recently there have been new drugs that have been approved that can directly target those abnormalities in a person's cancer cells.
The new drugs are so effective against tumors with these mutations that Bro says testing should be made an option for many cancer patients.
It's for people who have cancer who has not been cured, right? So if somebody had an early stage cancer, they had surgery and it's over with, there's no need to do this testing because what we're talking about is doing the type of testing that could uncover treatments for people who still have cancer in their body, recurrent cancer or maybe distant cancer. We call it metastatic cancer.
However, some cancers are more likely than others to have genes that respond to targeted therapy. For example, Bro says around 70% of thyroid cancers respond well. Overall, the tally is around 10%.
Even if it only changes the care for a subset of patients, these are people that you would not want to miss, because this treatment works so well. And we've done this before. You know, we will do treatments on multiple people, even knowing that only a subset of them are going to really, really benefit, because you don't want to miss that opportunity. And in this case, we can't predict who's going to have these markers that are going to make them amenable to these therapies. But these therapies are so good, you would never want to miss the opportunity.
Bro says that as more and more drugs are approved for gene-targeted therapy, it will make sense for more and more cancer patients to be tested. She's seen plenty of patients benefit already.
Another woman that I've met had very, very bad sarcoma, one of the worst, most aggressive tumors, does not respond to chemotherapy well, had two children, was in a wheelchair on oxygen with pretty much 50% of her lungs replaced by tumor. She started on these drugs and also was out within 2 months, was hiking with her kids. So these are not minor responses. These are major life-changing responses and certainly disease-changing trajectories. People who would have probably passed away within 3 months, 6 months, are not only doing well, but they're thriving. And in cancer, this is why we do it.
You can find out more about all our guests through links on our webpage, radiohealthjournal.net. You can also find archives of our programs there, as well as on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, and Spotify. Our studio producer is Jason Dickey. I'm Nancy Benson.
Radio Health Journal returns in just a moment.
When it comes to health, there is one area that can be difficult to talk about: colon health. Yet this critical area of well-being is heavily influenced by lifestyle choices. Research shows that 75% of colon cancer cases can be avoided by individual actions, and diet is one critical factor. Registered dietitian Courtney Romano is a health advisor for the California Table Grape Commission.
To promote colon health, experts advise a diet rich in whole plant-based foods and low in red meat, especially processed meat. An easy first step is to consume more vegetables and fruit, including grapes. Fresh grapes have over 1,600 naturally occurring beneficial plant compounds, including antioxidants and other polyphenols. Preliminary research suggests that consuming grapes every day may help support a healthy colon.
Maintaining a healthy diet and weight, not smoking, exercising regularly, and getting screened are other important colon health steps. Grapes of all colors, red, green, and black, are part of a healthy diet. Visit grapesfromcalifornia.com for more information.
Paid not attorney spokesperson, Fierce Nakawati, with principal office in Dallas, Texas. Attention landscapers and anyone working in the landscape industry. This is an important alert for users of the Weed Killer Roundup that have been diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. A California jury recently awarded $289 million to a landscaper who claimed Roundup gave him cancer. Roundup is the most widely used herbicide in the United States with billions of pounds applied each year. Farm workers and landscapers are at the highest risk of injury from exposure. Time is limited to file a claim. If you work with Roundup Weed Killer and were diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, don't wait. Call the Roundup Legal Helpline now. The number to dial is 800-208-0501. That number again is 800-208-0501. You could be entitled to significant compensation. If you've been exposed to Roundup and have been diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, don't wait. Call the Roundup Legal Helpline right now. 800-208-0501. That's 800-208-0501. Again, 800-208-0501. Call now.
What are you going to do with your old car? You can try selling it, you could junk it, or you can donate it to Heritage for the Blind. Your car will be towed away for free, and your donation is tax deductible. Just call 1-800-835-1478. Heritage for the Blind accepts cars, vans, trucks, and boats. It doesn't matter if your vehicle runs or not. It will be towed away for free, and you'll be supporting those that need help. Heritage for the Blind is a nonprofit organization that helps the visually impaired live fuller lives. Call right now to donate your car, and as a special thank you, you'll receive a free 3-day vacation voucher to over 50 locations. Call Heritage for the Blind right now. Call 1-800-835-1478. Donating is easy, and your vehicle is towed away for free. Plus, you'll get a free vacation voucher for donating. Call now, 1-800-835-1478. That's 1-800-835-1478.
Thank you for listening to Radio Health Journal, a production of MediaTrax Communications. If you enjoyed this broadcast, please support our show by subscribing, sharing it with a friend, and leaving a review on Apple Podcasts. You can find more Radio Health Journal stories about health, science, and technology on Apple Podcasts, Google Play, Spotify, and RadioHealthJournal.net. Also, follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Radio Health Journal. Coming up next week on Radio Health Journal.
She was completely out of control of her body, so she would scream and cry and run around the house.
J.C. Konechny's daughter Greta was a normal 5-year-old looking forward to starting kindergarten, but it changed in an instant after a case of strep throat.
Pulling things off walls, she was just completely out of control.
Then, if you procrastinate, you might be avoiding something bigger than the task at hand.
Procrastination really is an emotion-focused coping strategy. It's not a time management problem, it's an emotion management problem.
All that and more on Radio Health Journal.